Hello everyone, my name is Joshua Smay. I'm a product development engineer in ACT's Orbital Systems group. And today we're gonna go over different ways to mount aluminum ammonia or CCHPs to your systems. So let's say you have a hot component on your satellite and you're trying to take that heat to a cold radiator panel. And a great candidate to do that is an aluminum ammonia constant conductance heat pipe. But you're struggling to figure out how to actually mount that heat pipe to your hot component and to your whole cold component. So there's three main ways to actually attach a CCHP to your component. The first way is to utilize what we call an integral flange. So this would be when the flange itself, or the part that you would bolt through, is actually extruded with the aluminum envelope of the CCHP. So this is by far the easiest to manufacture because we don't need to go through any extra steps. It's all built right into the actual extrusion of the heat pipe itself. The second option is to use a round extrusion. So this would not have the flange built into it, rather it would just be a round pipe. And then you can either solder that round pipe into a block that you would bolt through, or you could epoxy it into a block that you would bolt through. Commonly, the blocks are called saddles. It's a more common term, but each of these have their own advantages and disadvantages. So the integral flange, as mentioned, is probably the easiest to manufacture, but it requires additional machining to take away the flange portion in areas where you're trying to bend it. So that's a little bit extra manufacturing steps, and it sort of restricts the orientation of the flanges as you're moving through space. The other two options allow you much more flexibility in terms of transitioning through space from hot to cold. But they're a little worse thermally. So the soldered option would be better than the epoxied option in terms of thermal performance. However, the soldered option requires, again, a few more manufacturing steps, such as plating the mating parts for solderability, as well as a little bit of change in the manufacturing flow of the heat pipe itself, because you have to solder the extrusion into the block first and then actually charge it with ammonia. So there's a few different steps there, advantages and disadvantages of each attachment method, but we can adapt it to whatever you need to get your CCHP into your satellite. So if you're interested in this sort of thing or would like any more information, fill out this contact form and we can get you in contact with one of our sales representatives and help you with your project.